Let's see what the Bible says. Wranglings of men, of corrupt minds, and destitute of the truth, who suppose that godliness is a means of gain. So people don't think they can make money off the gospel. They're wrangling men, destitute of the truth, corrupt mind. The Bible says, from such, withdraw yourself. Withdraw yourself from prosperity gospel preachers. Withdraw yourself from these false teachings that Jesus wants you to be healthy and wealthy. That Jesus wants to make you rich. What a load of garbage. Jesus didn't come to make you rich. He's going to make you happier, healthy. Jesus Christ came to make you holy. Holy, holy, holy. It goes on to say, now godliness with contentment is great gain. Are you content? If you have godliness with contentment, if you're seeking after riches and material possessions, then you're living in sin. That's all being his covenants. But we brought nothing into this world. Hold on a second. Brought nothing into this world. And then, sir, we can take nothing out. And having food and clothing, with this, we shall be content.
Let me ask you a question. Hold on. Did you know Kirk Franklin was involved with a pornography scandal? You didn't know that?
No, no, I knew about that.
Okay, but he's still a man of God, right?
Well, he wasn't during pornography looking, no.
But he's still a man of God.
Well, he repented.
Okay, he repented.
Right, but
he's a man of God.
But what would you think of him if he went back every once in a while and looked at pornography again? He wouldn't be a man of God anymore. And during his pornography addiction, he wasn't a man of God. I watched that show. I heard all about it. He was digging trash cans for pornography and throughout. But he wasn't a man of God at that point in time. And with God in his sin, he went straight to hell. And he knows that. That's why he rejects it now. If Kirk Franklin thought he could look at pornography and go to heaven, he wouldn't have ever stopped looking at it. But he stopped because he knew he was going to hell. Having food and clothing, with these we shall be content. Are you content with what God has given you? Are you always looking for more, for bigger, for better, for shinier? People like T.D. Jakes and Creflo Dollar and Joe Osteen and Ken Tolkien preaching this false gospel message. They need to repent. If they repent, they're going to hell themselves. I don't care how big their churches are, how fancy their cars are, how big their mansions are, how expensive their clothing is and their cufflinks. I don't care how many people they got going to a building twice a week. They're leading people to hell. And then you repent. But those who desire to be rich fall into temptation and a snare. And to many foolish and harmful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. These men who are preaching a false prosperity gospel message, they're drowning themselves in destruction in their sin, and they're leading themselves to destruction and perdition in hell, and they're leading many of you that way too, if you're believing them. The Bible says, but you, oh man, or woman of God, but you pursue, flee from these things, pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and goodness. Those are the things a godly person will pursue. Not the things of the world, not riches or possessions. If you love the world, you're enemy with God. And the Bible, if you love the world, you're on your way to hell in the end. But you must forsake the world. You must forsake your sin. The Bible says in the last days, people will gather around themselves, false teachers, and preach what their itching ears want to hear. People on here will make me rich, God. You're a big Walmart in the sky. Anytime I want something, I'll just go to you and you'll give it to me. A big Santa Claus in heaven. Oh, Santa, give me what I want. Doesn't work like that. God wants you to be holy. If you're not holy, you will not see the Lord. So friends, while you still have time, while your heart's still beating, while your lungs are still breathing, turn from sin, count the cost. See, your sin and your pleasure, you get what's going to cost you your very soul in the end. And you'll reap what you sow. And you're going to reap hell in the end. So if you're a fornicator, repent of your fornication. If you're a drunkard, repent of your drunkenness. If you're a drug user, repent of it. And turn to Christ. And he will cleanse you. If you're greedy, if you're selfish, repent. Turn to Christ. Love God above all else. Love your neighbor as self. And live a life of selflessness the rest of your days. Because God is worthy. Christ is worthy. He deserves your obedience. He deserves your love. He deserves your affections and your attention. Do it today, friend. Why will you go out on your sin?
Choose you where you're going.
Choose you this day whom you will serve. Choose to serve Christ, not yourself and Satan and sin. Serve Christ.